Hey everybody, I'm here to tell you who won the song contest from episode 46. The hint was given to us by Andrew Mogan, which is, Tim is off on a search to rescue the princess. Another game was Braid, and that was correctly guessed by Cody Peck. And he even told us the composer and which song it was, which he said it was Downstream by Shira Common. Congratulations, Cody, on the correct guess, and now you will be able to send us a song and hint for a future episode, so send it our way. I'll be back at the end of the episode to give you the hint and song for this episode. What's up, everybody, and welcome to another episode of Team Chat Podcast. I am one of your hosts, Jerrett Wilson, joined to my right by Rachel Mogan.
How's it going?
And to my left, Zachary Parks.
How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good. How's everyone?
Horrible.
Mogan's not having a great week.
We've already talked about this.
But now it's time for Team Chat.
That's right, that's
right. And
that
means smiles and happy
faces
all around.
It's a good way to wrap up my week.
It is.
Because otherwise it would end on a terrible note. So this is a good...
release thing.
Exactly. A good way to... So I've been in a horrible mood all week. And last night I was gaming Overwatch Online with my bros. And usually I'm like support / tank. The entire time we were in competitive, I was only DPS.
Nice.
Killing it. Raging on other people. And they were like, well, you're playing really aggressively tonight. And I was like, yeah, I'm going to
shut your mouth. Shut up and get behind me.
And we were on a winning streak. So it's worth noting that it helped.
Yeah. Just focus. Laser focus.
Good to know that you can go both offense and support.
I know.
So.
I'm a Pharah.
Love to blow
people to smithereens at close range.
Mm. Nice.
I know she's supposed to be like a distance character, but that's not how I play it.
It's not how you do it.
Yeah, no, I get right up in your
special
face.
At like ground level.
Exactly. I'm a grounded Pharah.
You're like walking and doing
I
it
walk
if you could.
Around and shoot. It's exactly the idea.
Nice. But in case you didn't know, Team Chat Podcast is a video gaming podcast where we talk about games, obviously, the ones we love, the ones we hate, and everything in between. And we do that through lists, reviews, general discussion, debates, and guests. Every once in a while. not every time, but every once in a while.
Every once in a while.
And if you would like to send us some feedback or get in touch with the show, send us a topic idea or a general question, comment, whatever, you can do that by sending us an email at teamchatpodcast@gmail.com or following us on Facebook and Twitter, Team Chat Podcast, respectively, and subscribing to our YouTube channel, youtube.com/teamchatpodcast, where you can watch the episodes in video format, as well as some episode highlights, game clips, and bonusodes. It's fun. You should check it out to get that full Team Chat experience. And if you would like to support the show, you can do just that. And just like one of our favorite listeners has just started doing, Bro Mogan, thank you very much for supporting us on the Patreon.
Thank you, bro.
The blood tie.
But check us out.
The unbroken bond.
I think I brought it up enough that he was finally like, okay, right. I'll do it. I was like, yeah, so, couldn't help but notice, bro.
We don't coerce donations.
No, of course not. That would be unethical.
That's like the mob.
Mogan just
we're not the mafia.
Strongly advises that you do it for your own good.
It was more like a constant stream of guilt tripping. Yeah. Like, gosh, it sure would be nice.
Right.
If
you sure do listen to it a lot.
You
that's,
sure,
you
mean,
know, real
you
passive.
Say you're a
you win,
fan,
the,
but
you win
are
those
you?
Song contests all the time. You know,
you sound like you're really enjoying it.
This is a pay to win situation. If you want to,
that's right.
You want to keep participating, right. You got to pay off.
It's not. That's why we move the contest
it's
to
not,
Wednesdays at
not.
9 a.m. So that way
that's
the people.
Right.
So that way people who
that's
do
right.
have the early access won't have an edge up.
Right.
That's right. And paying does not get you an advantage.
No.
That's right.
It's just a nice bonus for us.
It is. It is. To help us do the cool things with the show.
Make it better.
Make it
exactly.
better.
Exactly. It's all to improve the show.
Yeah.
But if you don't feel like supporting us on Patreon, that's totally fine. We understand. Not everyone has bucks to toss or want to toss his bucks.
I don't support the show.
I know. I mean, we're in the show. We just do it by our time. Our, you know, the time that we'll never get back.
That's right. Yeah. The time. How many hours have we lost doing this show?
But that's totally fine because we will continue to do the show each and every week and provide you with great content because we love doing it. That's the Team Chat promise. The Team Chat
guarantee.
I love that we're all in sync on it now and it's
we're
a thing.
We're getting good at
this. I like
show.
That it's a
yeah,
thing.
Finally.
Only 48 episodes in. Or whatever.
47. Close. 47.
You have to keep me engaged so that I don't space out.
We'll yeah. see. And that's what we're doing. We're, yeah. We asked you yeah. how your week was. You told
yeah, there,
us.
There
and,
you
now,
go.
And now you're like synced in.
Cater
keyed
to
in.
Me.
Yes.
This is the show for me.
So... at the beginning of this episode, you were paid a visit by future by past Jarrett, future Jarrett, whatever. I can't figure out the timelines yet. To let you know who won the song contest, and so future Jarrett again will be filling you in because I don't know at this point who won this, who wins the song contest from the last Jarrett. From the last episode from episode 46. I don't even know.
Yeah.
But future Jarrett knows, and he'll show up at the end of the episode to play the clip for the new one. So we'll just skim right on because again we are having to pre-record some of these episodes. This episode, but
I like future Jarrett.
You like future Jarrett? I don't know. He rubs me the wrong way.
No,
I don't know.
He's kind of a dick.
He's
right?
Kind of an asshole.
Just showing up, giving
future Jarrett,
telling orders and like telling people how it's done, you know, or whatever. Man, take it easy. Kind of an asshole.
I want to say real quick that I hope everyone enjoyed this little future thing here. I hope everyone enjoyed the last episode that just came out, which is now in this time and space that people are hearing this.
The anniversary one.
Is the anniversary episode.
Yeah,
the Let's Talk About Team Chat podcast or whatever.
That was a fun one. I really enjoyed that one.
Yeah,
that was a fun one to get to rehash and look back on our year. Can you tone down the fan just one? Mm-hmm. I just realized it was at full power.
That's full power?
No, that one. No,
turn
it's not full power,
up.
I don't think. But
do
I would,
it.
I forgot
pull
to
the switch.
I forgot to turn it down. So that
green
way
or red?
Like,
red or which wire do I cut?
They're all blue.
Okay, so, but that brings us now, since Future Jarrett filled us in on the song.
Thanks.
Thank you, Future Jarrett.
Don't hurt us.
You're welcome from the future.
Stop manipulating time.
It is time now to get into our topic for the show, which is we are going to talk about some of our favorite achievements or trophies that we have earned in our gaming exploits.
A super fun topic.
It is a fun topic and one that I don't feel like gets much play, but trophies are a really awesome things. Now, I have more trophies than achievements because I'm predominantly PlayStation, and I assume Mogan is as well.
Yes.
Nintendo have anything?
Oh, no.
Okay.
No.
I didn't think they did.
Heavens
no.
No.
Nintendo
no.
is like, we don't want to make it a competition,
let's
okay?
Just be like
everyone wins.
Everybody's winning. Everyone's a winner. You all get participation trophies. So the real trophy is friendship when it comes to
the
Nintendo.
The real trophy is just buying the system.
Seriously.
Thank you.
Thanks.
That's your trophy.
Just believing in their future.
That's
looking
right.
at you, Nintendo Switch.
Yeah, seriously.
But yeah, so we just want to talk about like what we like what they what we feel like they add to the games, and then some of the favorite ones that we've been able to achieve in the past.
So as far as the past goes, I was thinking about it earlier. We kind of touched on it. Trophies and achievements have not been a thing in gaming for that long.
They
like,
really
like,
haven't.
It, like it's older. Like we were talking Xbox 360 and
first,
PS3 had
were the
it.
First systems that I remember.
But I don't know. Like in my timeline of my brain, that's not that long ago. Like objectively, I know it is. But
ago.
I still kind of look at trophies and achievements as like a new thing.
Yeah.
I guess part of that's because I'm mostly Nintendo, so obviously we don't have that kind of stuff, and so it's like with my PS4 I'm getting more of these types of trophies and achievements and things, but it's just not that much in my wheelhouse.
Yeah, and I mean I don't remember them until I think you were saying that the original Xbox didn't have them, and I'm pretty sure you're right on that one, and then obviously I don't think PS2 or anything had it. I believe it all started with PS3. We should probably fact check that.
I'm pretty sure they didn't have
before we go spilling lies.
In achievements. I mean, I think there's stuff online that perhaps synced up to the game in some way where you could, for Grand Theft Auto, for example, if you did this and this and this, but those are more maybe like cheat codes or secrets.
Yeah,
you know?
Secrets
and so,
like inside the game, pre-built in kind of
right,
thing that you could achieve.
Exactly, and people online talking about, oh, if you could do X, Y, and Z, this happens. And that
right.
was sort of, and so that was actually something that I was going to bring up is as much as I think I like achievements, now I'm kind of coming from an opposite place as Mogan. I feel like they've been around for a long time. I felt like they've been making their rounds, and I thought they were really, really cool when they first came out, and I was interested in trying to get them. Over the past couple of years, though, I've all but like ignored them, really.
Yeah.
And that's only unless there's a really cool achievement, something really interesting.
And I feel like there's two types of gamers, really. There are the ones who like to go after the achievements and get all the trophies, and
right.
the ones who just like to play the game and then just see what happens. I feel like I'm in the middle where I like to get them. It's a cool little, like, you know, adrenaline or dopamine, whatever it is, whatever mental chemical
right.
it is in your head that you get from being like, oh yes, I achieved something.
Right.
But I'm like, and it depends on the game for me too.
It depends
sometimes
on the game,
I start
it depends
a game
on the achievement too. Some like
right.
they're like, you know, start the game. That's an achievement. Now some of them are so mundane and boring to me that throws me off. It's
well because
be
right
the,
now
the
they're have to because it is a thing they have to have them.
Yeah.
They do. I know it's ding 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 ding. It's part of the system. It's like you're scoring. You're doing something.
Right.
You know
keeping
I mean?
people. people involved, the gamification of a game.
My least favorite type of trophy are like the gimmies. Like I've noticed this a lot with, actually one of the ones that I'm going to talk about that has a few that I really love is the Portal series. But Portal is also very guilty of doing like the opposite thing that I know, sorry. I don't realize I'm doing it. It's like the opposite thing that I don't like, where if you just get to a certain point in the game that was already built in, like you were going to have to do this thing, there's no way around it, and it gives you a trophy for that. Mm-hmm. It'll be like, oh, hey, you just got to such and such. Right. Here, have a trophy. And I'm like, what for? That's not, well, like in my head,
Call
that's
of
not
Duty
what
and, for. And stuff like that. They do that too. It's like you beat a level, yeah, and it's like you gimmies. Get this one.
Yeah. And it's like, why'd you even have
that's
this?
Not, like, that's not an achievement.
It's not an achievement. Not. That's not something that anyone should be rewarded for. The reward is playing.
But I feel like those are more in place to be just to be like progression markers or completion markers, rather than like, you did something great, here's a trophy. And that's normally why they're, you know, like if you, like on a Call of Duty game, if you play the game and you beat a level on easy or normal, it's, you know, on PlayStation anyway, it's a bronze trophy.
Yeah.
Very easy to get. If you do it on hard, it's a silver trophy or something like
that. Now, that I understand. Like, the difference of difficulties, I get that. But just for progressing through the game, like, I understand what you're saying with, like, percentage markers.
Right.
Like, progressing. But why not just scrap all the progress reports, what do we used to have in school?
Yeah, progress
report cards.
Report cards.
Yeah. All the report cards, and just go with the ones that are like the fun stuff.
Yeah.
And that would actually change the percentage rate, of course, and you would just have a pool of the fun optional trophies. I like that approach a lot better than like the progress markers.
Yeah.
I mean, I kind of agree. I feel much more accomplished if I do something, especially coming back to Portal. I'm looking at some of the achievements here. There are some really interesting
My favorite types of trophies are the ones that are 100% missable. So yes. I love hidden trophies.
Yeah.
And whenever I see like a game, you know, it'll kind of tell you, especially in PlayStation 4, it'll be like, hey, these are all hidden trophies. And I'm like, yes, I love hidden trophies. Things that you would have to actually just sort of stumble upon or actively cheat and look them up.
Right.
I never cheat. I never look them up.
Most of those, though, are always story related.
Yeah.
Like Until Dawn. A lot of every trophy in Until Dawn is hidden.
Nice.
But that makes sense, because if you're looking at trophies and you could see them, that would spoil some
but
of the
But like a good,
game.
I mean, obviously these aren't story related, but like, for example, Overwatch, every single trophy is listed out including exactly what you have to do to get them.
But that's good though.
So it is good.
Because like if you're trying to platinum that game, like you would be guessing for forever what you were supposed
to do. But I also kind of feel like it'd be a nice surprise to like do something and get a trophy for it and be like, oh,
Yeah,
I like to be surprised. I like to be like blindsided and be like, awesome, I did something great. And it's like, oh yeah, 99.9% of gamers have this. And I'm like, oh, never mind.
There's one in Halo. I don't think it might be an achievement. It's definitely a secret like medal, and it's the Combat Evolved medal in Halo 5.
Yeah.
And basically that is, and I never knew about it. People had to tell me about it or find out randomly about it. And I actually think I found out randomly about it. I was like, whoa, what was that? Like, I'd never seen that medal or achievement pop up before. What was that? And it took me a while, but basically in the original Halo, it was really easy to grenade a weapon towards you. They had these physics where they just fly through the air.
I've seen people do that.
Right, and if you catch it in midair, you know, it's pretty cool. So now in Halo 5, if you grenade a weapon towards you and catch it, he'll be like, Combat Evolved. And like,
that's pretty badass.
And that never happens. You know, you never realize that stuff. So that was a really cool secret.
See, I love that kind of stuff. Like just the little tiny things where you're like, oh, nice. I love that that's a trophy. Mm-hmm. That's the kind of stuff that like really gets me about trophies. When you're not expecting it, you don't know what it is. It just kind of happens. And sometimes you're like, what did I do? Mm-hmm. Like, what did I even do to prompt this trophy?
Well, and what's fun too, and Halo's really good about this, is it has like its own like built-in like mods almost or secrets with the skulls.
Yeah, the skulls
that you can find.
Oh my god! Well, Halo, Halo in general. I mean,
Grunt Birthday Party is like one of my favorites.
Yeah.
Wait, so tell me what the skulls are.
They're literally like these golden skulls or something like that. I think did they start in Halo 3 or were they before?
Halo 2.
Halo 2.
They're in Halo 2.
And so basically, they're just hidden throughout the levels,
and they're really hard to find.
So they're actual objects.
These are like Easter eggs.
Okay.
You pick them up, and it unlocks some like small feature for the game.
And sometimes it does it automatically. So there's one called Blind, and that's just a way to play the game. So as soon as you pick it up, your HUD, like your aimer, your health, your radar just goes away, and you're blind, and it's just nothing.
The one I was saying is like one of my favorites is Grunt Birthday Party,
right?
Where if you headshot grunts, confetti blows up, and they go, and it goes, yay!
That's hilarious.
For me, Halo is like one of the best. I mean, Bungie, the amount of Easter eggs they have, and they also have terminals in Halo 3, I think, when they started doing that. And terminals are also secret locations that go into backstory about... Shoot, maybe Halo 2 had it too. Yeah, maybe, I think Halo 2 had it too. Backstory of the Halo universe. Stuff that you would have to either find in the books, stuff that no one knows about. So there's all that stuff too, which are sort of like achievements.
Yeah.
You know, they're not the built-in to the Xbox thing. Actually, right. I'm sure actually that if you find one, that you do get an achievement. You know, actually, they're probably the same thing. But yeah, those secret ones like that are always been fascinating to me. And I love a game that can do it well.
My other favorite type of trophy are the ones that are just really straight up stupid. One of the best examples I can think of is actually really kind of two examples. Firewatch, which actually only has six trophies, period.
Hmm.
And Tomb Raider, which has 80 bajillion.
Yeah.
In Tomb Raider, this would be this square, the Crystal Dynamics one from 2012. Of course, most people go around shooting game, like, you know, rabbits, crows, big deer, things like that. But there's a certain section where spoiler alert, guys, watch out. There's a certain section where if you're on the beach and you shoot a crab, like you get a crab cakes trophy, and it's like for a crab, just like a stupid little crab that you really can't even loot. Like you can't do anything with it, but it's like you shot a crab. Good job.
You can build armor out of their shells. So,
and that's
you know.
The kind of crap that I'm like, yes.
I love that.
I love to shoot crabs.
You would never
like,
expect that you'd get a little
stupid shit where it's just like,
up.
I will shoot these crabs, and then you get a trophy for it, and you're like, awesome.
That's hilarious.
So Far Cry 3 had one like that, because in their advertising and marketing for Far Cry 3, they had some TV spots that came out with the actor who plays Voss, the who I talked about. I believe his name is Michael Mondo, I believe is his name. And he's doing like these, there were a few of them and all together, or they were webisodes or something like that. And all together, it equaled like 30 minutes of content. And he was, but in these episodes with him were Christopher Mintz-Plasse. McLovin from Superbad.
McLovin from Superbad.
And so, but in one of them, Voss buries Christopher in the sand in the beach.
Yeah.
But then somewhere in the game, you can actually go and find Christopher Mintz-Plasse dead, buried in the sand.
That's hilarious.
And that's like an Easter egg, and I believe it's a trophy as well.
Nice. Oh, that's a good time. That's the kind of stuff that I love
extra mile.
To death.
Right.
The extra
just like
mile.
A little funny thing that like I didn't even know that those webisodes existed until after I had played the game and read about that trophy and achievement. I was like, oh, that's really funny.
And
really
I would love the opposite, where you find it on total accident. You had no idea about the webisodes. So you just find this dead body and get this trophy, and you're like, what the snick snack did I get this trophy for?
Yeah.
Who's this dead guy in the sand? What the hell is happening here? I love both sides of that. Like knowing what it is and getting the joke, and not knowing what it is and not getting the joke, but still finding it.
Yeah.
I love that.
Back to Portal for a second. I was reading some of the achievements. There's a couple in particular that I really like. Portal's a really perfect game for having these great achievements. I think is a simple one, but hard to do, is progressing through the game either without getting shot or without taking damage.
Yeah.
You know, that sort of stuff is those are achievements that I read and I'm like, I want to try to do that.
Yeah, because even though it's not, I mean, Portal isn't a super violent game, but there are like turrets and there are ways that you can easily get injured if you're not being careful.
Yeah.
So it's relatively hard to die unless you fall. Like falling deaths is the vast majority of the way I die.
Uh-huh.
But if you do actually get shot to death, it's like, oh, well, that was an unpleasant surprise.
Yes.
So I think the first time a turret shot at me, I was like, what the hell?
I know, because they're so cute.
So then it's like,
they're
if you
so
get
adorable.
Shot then,
it's so nice.
That ruined your chance for that playthrough of getting the trophy.
So it's like if they surprise you, you're like, whoa, there goes the trophy.
Who's there? Hello.
Hello. Are you still there?
Are you still there? Yeah, that's great.
One of my favorite ones is actually, what's it actually called? I wrote it down.
I love those black turrets in the hit
too.
Oh,
me
too. They're
the,
like, have the different personality.
Defective turrets.
Yeah,
I love,
so funny.
There's actually that one where you know the part of Portal 2, spoiler alert, where you remove the good turret from the sample,
uh-huh.
and you're meant to put in the defective turret to have it start churning out defective turrets.
Uh-huh.
The one of the trophies that I really like is you can remove the regular turret, but instead of immediately putting in the defective turret, you get into the scanner. Like you jump into the scanner and it scans you. I don't remember what the trophy is called, but it's really funny. And it like it achieves the same goal. It like messes with the system, but it's like, that's hilarious. Because I wouldn't have normally thought to jump into the scanner myself. Right. And that's the kind of stuff I love about Portal and about trophies in general.
Well, the one that's like not getting shot, I love how it changes the way you play the game. You could it adds a whole new layer to the game that allows you to play it differently. And that's really fun. There's another one on there called Trap Like a Rat. Did you ever do that one in the original Portal?
Oh, no, I don't think
so. So that one is really interesting. That is basically you have to figure out how to get yourself in a situation in one of the test chambers where it is impossible for you to move forward without GLaDOS helping you.
Oh.
So I was like, I read that achievement. I was like, how in the world do you do that? Do you make it so the game...
That's awesome.
You're unable to progress further, and GLaDOS has to like teleport you over somewhere else. Basically, I remember what I think I did. It was an early test chamber where basically you're in a room. There's a glass wall in front of you with a little box opening at the top, and you're supposed to shoot a portal through that opening into the other room, shoot one side into where the room you're in, and kind of go through. But there's a box there, or a crate, or like a...
Cubes.
The cubes. And... if you pick it up and basically put it in that little box window, it blocks it so you can't shoot out. And GLaDOS like gets on. She comes on the intercom and she says, I forget what she says, but she's like, how did you do? You
know, something really snarky.
Yeah, I'm sure something snarky. And I remember like, that is such a cool achievement.
I love Portal is full of great achievements. Yeah. One of the other ones that... I love the ones that play to my personal playing style, which is, I have to save all the things. Yeah. And there's that one part. You can do it, I think it... No, maybe it is just one part of the game. There's that part where you are actually progressing to where all of the defective turrets are being destroyed, you know, because they're defective. And on the way, there's the conveyor belt, and there's like a defective turret laying on it, but it's still awake. And leading up to that, you had actually kind of seen it a couple of times before, but like you couldn't get to it, but you could hear it go, help me, are you still there? And then eventually you get to the point where you can actually get to it, and you can either just totally leave it and keep progressing, and it's 100% optional. But if you're like me, and you bother to pick up the turret and carry it with you, it'll be like, thank you, and you get a trophy for it, and it's called like No Hard Feelings for saving a turret.
That's
like,
awesome.
I'll save you, little buddy. Then it'll like say nice things at you throughout the whole rest of until you eventually drop it. I mean, you can't carry it forever, but that's the kind of crap I love, where it's like, nothing happens. You don't get anything for saving this turret other than peace
just
of mind.
Going out of your way to
a
save
clean
it. Be a
conscience.
Good Samaritan.
Exactly.
There's one for the companion cube, like the nice one, the one with the heart on. I think there's an achievement if you can figure out how not to throw it in the fire pit in the first portal, because basically she gives it to you and she's like, this is your new companion cube, learn to love it, you know, blah blah blah. And then the twist at the end is you have to destroy it yourself. And you're like, oh no. And
you gotta, like,
you gotta throw it in the fire pit. And I think there's an achievement if you can somehow figure out how to avoid that. I forget how it works.
Awesome.
I think
so. Deus Ex Mankind Divided is talking about these ones that affect your playthrough, like not getting shot by turrets, stuff like this. Yeah. But so this is an interesting way. Like, you have to choose how to do this. So like, for me to get these trophies, I'd have to go play through the game again. But it has one pacifist. It's a gold trophy. You completed, and it says, you completed Deus Ex Mankind Divided without killing a single soul.
Wow.
Bosses are people too.
How do you not kill a boss?
So that means that there's ways to get around bosses without killing, which is interesting.
Oh, that's a cool idea.
And then here's this one, Foxes to the Hounds. You triggered zero alarms during an entire playthrough, which that is hard to do.
I bet.
That means you cannot be seen by enemies, or they can't be alerted. They can see you and then be suspicious and look around for you, but they can't see you and like raise the alarm or whatever.
That changes the way you play the game, which is great.
Right.
It's like,
I tried to be pacifist for as long as I could on my first playthrough. Now, you can like knock them unconscious or stun them. You just can't kill them.
Okay.
And I tried to do that, and then I finally just got so...
Dishonored. Like, Dishonored has a lot of that kind of stuff, too. And there are a lot of ways to get around bosses, per se. Because I don't think Dishonored has bosses the same way that Deus Ex does. But there are still ways to basically get around the objective without killing whatever the target or whatever the original goal was. And I love that kind of stuff. It's my favorite stuff.
And that's cool, because if you are the type to come back and want to be the completionist and get that kind of stuff, you know, it gives replayability to the
game. Yeah, I mean, it would
game.
Require you to play the game in two radically different ways, or even more, depending on the play style. So it's like, it's a great way to build more incentive into the game.
Right.
When you're creating these kind of less progress report style trophies and these more optional different path kind of trophies. I like that approach a lot more. Mm-hmm.
So what is it for you guys when you're playing one and you decide to say like I've only platinum two games, gotten all the trophies that you can get for them. I want to do more. It was actually a goal of mine this year to platinum three games, and that is not happening.
You've got like two more months.
I have two.
You can do it.
I have two. I have to do two more. I got one earlier this year. Far Cry Primal, platinum that one. And but what for you triggers in the like when you're playing the game, or maybe even before you even play the game, to where you're like, this is one I want to platinum, or what's it called when you get them all for Xbox? Just like completion, 100%
yeah,
completion.
It's not the same as PlayStation, right? Or, like they've done a little bit more in depth, I think.
I think they have too, because they have like the tiers, Xbox. The four tiers of trophy: bronze, silver, gold, platinum.
Yeah, different rarity.
Right,
Xbox has like you get 50 points for a good trophy or a good achievement, maybe 100.
Which
really
with Xbox, the you know that gamer score converts to currency, right, that you can use to buy and use stuff in the score.
I don't think so.
Not anymore.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah,
I feel like that was a thing at one point.
Do you mean real world currency?
Well, it's like you get amount of gamer score or something like that, and you can like trade it in to get. And they could have killed this. I could be completely speaking out of ignorance. I feel like there was something. This was before I had an Xbox, yeah.
I don't remember that.
That sounds like such an exploitable system.
Right, and I think that's why they might have killed
it.
Yeah, I don't... I mean, GamerScore was cool for me for the first 6 months, maybe, of the Xbox 360, and then everyone has, like, 1,430. Now this guy has 3,220. It's like, I don't really know. It's cool when I had, like, 100, and my friends had 50. I'm like, I'm beating you, but now we all have, like, thousands, and...
The only time I care about trophies at all is, again, when they're surprises and they just kind of happen.
Yeah.
I never approach a game and think I'm going to platinum this. Literally not ever.
Really?
And that's not a goal. Like, that's absolutely a moot point for me. If I happen to platinum it, that would be super.
Have you?
No.
Never platinum one?
No, because I'm not trying.
Yeah.
And for a lot of those, especially, like, Tomb Raider has a bunch of these where it's like, oh, shoot 10 enemies off a zip line, and that's a trophy. Or like, oh, kill this many people in this particular way, and that's a trophy. And that's just not the kind of player that I am, and it's also not something that I'm going to actively seek out because I just don't care.
Right.
Like, I love the silly fun trophies or the surprise ones, but I don't give a crap about the more achievement-oriented trophies that are like, here's a goal, go out and do it.
Yeah.
And I'm like, no, you're not the boss of me.
I'm like 100% similar in that regard. I will say, I talked about this game early on in our podcast, but I got really close. I ended up doing it, but I realized I was close with, and it's, people are fucking laugh at this because it has like 8 achievements, but Marvel Blast Ultra.
Oh, yeah.
That's the only game.
Which is and you Xbox. Got them all?
I got them all, and that's a great Xbox Live Arcade game.
Oh,
that's
hilarious.
I keep that in high regards for games. I love that game. And one of the last achievements, I remember I had them all. I was like, I've never gotten all the achievements for a game. I had like, 7 out of 8. And I was like, I want to get the last one. Basically, the last one is finding all the Easter eggs.
Ooh,
and
nice.
So, and they're just
that'd be
in
hard.
The trickiest places. Ooh. They are in the weirdest places. And me and my buddy went through and we found them all. It was just a nice extra layer to the game.
Right.
It really was a good achievement. And we got all the achievements. And I was like, okay, I did it once.
That kind of makes me think probably the only game that I even have the potential to platinum is actually Firewatch. Because like I said, it only has 6 trophies. Mm-hmm. I already have 4. Actually, I might have 5.
Oh, yeah. You should go for it.
I'm only missing one trophy. And I haven't done my second playthrough yet. So this is actually a game that I did finish. And I want to go back and play it again because A, it's short. B, it has...
Right?
Exactly. You can play it differently regarding your choices and how you choose to respond to Delilah and interact with the environment. And all of those trophies, or really at least, well, not all, half, probably 3 of them are just really silly trophies. 2 of the ones that I've already gotten are, you can optionally find a turtle, just kind of sitting on a rock, and you can radio Delilah and go, hey, I found a turtle, and she's like, good for you, and you can pick up the turtle and like observe him, and then you can put him back down, or you can pick up the turtle and keep him, and he is your friend, and I was like, oh, I'm keeping the turtle, this is my pet now, and this is a really good example of, it doesn't change the game, but it has a funny outcome. If you choose to keep the turtle, A, you get a trophy, of course. Mm. B, way later in the game, you find a sketchbook that I think is Delilah's. And one of the pages is like a drawing she did of you. And if you found the turtle, the turtle is in the drawing. Hilarious. And I was like, my turtle!
Did you name the turtle?
You get three choices of what you it's can like name Frank. The turtle. And no, I think, oh, I picked, Dorothy. I picked... Sid. It was a pun on Turt Reynolds.
Turt Reynolds.
I was like, hilarious. That's very funny. And I think one of the others is like, get stung by a bee. I was like, okay.
That's the name of it?
Yeah, get no, I got by stung bee. By a bee. And like, that was the That's trophy. That's the trophy. And I was like, hurrah. And I think the only trophy I'm missing is, I believe, there is a raccoon somewhere in the game that has the potential to attack you.
Ooh.
And getting attacked by the raccoon is a trophy, and that's the one I'm missing.
<Straight up.
laughs> So I think I'm going to go back and be like, where is this goddamn raccoon that I'm going to start a fight with? I'm looking forward to that. What I don't know is he only going to be out at night? Where is
they
he?
Are yeah. fairly nocturnal.
I know, nocturnal so I'm that's exactly what I'm going to do, wander around at night.
Savages, I hear.
Actively be looking careful. For a stupid raccoon.
So for me, it's kind of a mixture. Now that I have platinum some games, I'm hooked on the feeling of platinum. It's a drug, you know.
I'm addicted
to platinum. That being said, I've still only done two games, and I did them
the
all
Last
recently.
Of the Us first, is one.
No, I haven't. Ooh. I still haven't. That's
been
my
a year in the making.
That's my long term. That was another goal for this year, to platinum Last of Us. Then I realized how big of an undertaking that is going to be. That's going to take a while to do.
Yeah.
Mostly because to do it, you have to. So. Obviously, the ones that are like beat the game at a certain difficulty level. If you beat a game at a higher difficulty level than what you have, it gives you the trophies for all those. So it's not like you have to go back and play it again for those. But I think to get them all, I would have to do it. To get all the main game ones, I need to play it two more times. Because you have to do it on Survivor and then Survivor Plus.
Oh.
But then there's also the DLC Grounded mode, which is incredibly hard. Same thing. You have to do, you put a playthrough on Grounded and then Grounded Plus.
So I have a question, actually. So if you didn't have the DLC and you finished the game with all the trophies available to you,
that technically
would
is
that
a
count? Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
You don't have to get
to say,
all the DLC.
Whoa, that would be hella unfair. No,
right,
that makes
right, right.
sense.
No,
that
you,
makes
you
sense.
Have to. Like, okay. So for me, it's normally I'll be playing the game and get really into it and then decide, yes, I want to platinum this game. It's funny, the two games I have platinumed were I was going along playing the game, realized I had 80% of the trophies and said, oh, all right, I might as well platinum this one. That's kind of how it happened with Shadow of Mordor and Far Cry Primal, the two games that I have.
Shadow of Mordor,
yeah.
Gotcha.
The two games that I platinumed, I just got into them, got really into them. I was like, oh yeah, might as well. Nice. Last of Us is the one that I was that from the beginning. And once I, well, no, same thing with that one. Once I realized how good it was, I was playing it. It was, and I was like, this one I'm going to platinum.
Yeah. So that's, you know, like more of an extra, you're like, it's out of honor for the game.
Yeah. It's more, it definitely, you know, is. Like a Call of Duty, something like that. I'm never going to try to platinum a Call of Duty. Mainly
yeah.
because
no,
that will
no,
take, that
no.
will take forever. Yeah. And I never play the zombies mode.
Yeah,
and that's okay. They have trophies on the zombies mode. I don't like the zombies
a
mode.
A lot.
Really.
I totally get that.
And
like,
so I'm not going to do that.
Yeah, like with Tomb Raider, we've talked about this. There technically is a multiplayer mode, and a lot of the trophies from Tomb Raider are attached to that mode.
But you're
I'm
like, you're
never going to play that mode ever.
Especially if it's a game that really doesn't need
yeah,
a multiplayer.
It has
yeah.
no need for multiplayer.
Deus Ex Mankind Divided is the same way. It has a multiplayer version, and it has some... trophies to go along with that.
Yeah.
I'm not going to get those. But Last of Us did have multiplayer trophies, but I love the Last of Us multiplayer. It was a really, really engaging.
It looks fun whenever I saw clips of you playing it. I was like, man, that game looks good.
It's really brutal, and
yeah,
so, and
it
so it really puts you into it. I loved it, all about it. And I have gotten all of the multiplayer trophies. That was the big, across DLC too, DLC and in-game.
Nice.
There are only two, which is nice for the original game trophies, which are you have to complete the Hunter journey and the Firefly journey.
Hmm.
But those are hard to do because what the journey is in the multiplayer is you have a 12-week period that you have to lead your clan of either the Fireflies or the Hunters, the two factions in the game.
Mm-hmm.
And so, but that means 7 days. So you have to play 7 rounds for 12 weeks before that's like the completion.
Oh, consistently.
I mean,
in real time.
No.
Oh, gosh.
Just
okay.
over time in game time.
Okay.
But so each round is a day.
basically. Mm. So 7 times 12, quick math for whoever's faster at it than me. 84?
No.
64.
Yeah.
64 matches. So you have to do 64, but then times 2, 128.
Mm-hmm.
You have to do 128 matches to effectively win, get those trophies. But the problem is there are all these missions that pop up throughout the game. And a few times throughout the 12 weeks, there will be a mission that is, if you fail it, you lose 100% of your clan population.
Ooh.
And you have to restart your journey over because your whole clan got killed. So potentially, you could play more, you could be doing more than those 128 rounds to get your trophies. Fortunately, I lucked out and was able to do it and survived and was able to get them on the first go through.
So kind of on that note, are there any trophies that you are aware of that you still haven't been able to get even though you've actively been trying?
Yes, several in Overwatch.
Me too. Man.
Overwatch is one I'm trying to platinum.
My bro is too. I'm not trying, but like it would be nice to have more of them, and a few I've gotten on accident. But man,
it's
Overwatch has some killer trophies.
And they're never looked at.
And they're hard ones that I feel like I should have gotten by now. So I almost feel like most of them are definitely right place, right time kind of trophies.
Yeah.
But then there are also ones that you can plan for.
Yeah.
So the biggest ones for me that I'm trying and cannot get are killing two people with a single use of Genji's Deflect.
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
That one's hard.
Really hard.
Yeah. And
I mean, a lot of the times you need like a Bastion to deflect and someone's really close to him.
Or like an ult to go off right in your face and you deflect.
Yeah.
It's so hard. And I feel like there have been many situations where I could have done it, but it just hasn't happened for me yet.
It just didn't happen.
And then Whole Hog for Roadhog, knocking two people off. And killing them environmentally with your ultimate.
Oh, that's cool.
That's a good one for Ilios.
Ilios, and I always try it for Ilios and Nepal.
The one
inside the temple.
Oh, yes. That's a great one. Sanctuary. Yes.
Sanctum. Yeah. So those are the two ones. And Genji and Roadhog are my main characters. I've played several hours, you know, like many hours as those two characters, and I've not been able to do it yet, and it's driving me crazy.
The ones that I'm really bad about getting all of the ones at this point. I feel like it would have been so much easier to do when the game was still new, but at this point, everyone already knows all the counters, so I'm having a lot of trouble with a lot of the quad kills.
Yes.
Like with Junkrat's Riptire, kill 4. I'm lucky if I get 3.
Mm.
With Divas.
I did just get Divas the other day.
Oh, lucky. I've been jonesing for it, but I haven't gotten it yet.
I did it. I shot off the nerf, and right as I was about to explode, like it was about to explode, and everybody had scattered off of the payload. The Zarya on our team fired her ult.
Nice.
Like at the right as it was, my ult was about to go
credit
off.
To
so she sucked him in right at the last second.
Awesome.
And I was able to get him. Yeah, so that was totally because of that Zarya.
I got the McCree one early on.
Thanks to Zarya.
I did too.
It's four.
It's four with Deadeye, and all of a sudden I got an achievement. I was like, that feels like it should be an achievement.
That one's hard.
Yeah,
too.
That was like one of my early games. I was like, I feel like that's not going to happen.
Because now everybody realizes, like, oh, you get behind something and it's fine. Same with D.Va.
Oh, yeah.
But
I mean, all you have to do is be behind the payload.
Yeah.
Like, that's such an easy one to dodge now that I know how to do it. But sometimes I'll still have, like, a panic moment. I'm like, where is it?
Yeah,
and
like,
then
what?
I die.
Same with a high noon with Deadeye.
What do you say?
You hear him say that, and you're like...
Yeah, I know. You do.
It's like that SpongeBob meme where he's like...
That's right. Everything's blurry behind him.
Caveman SpongeBob, where he's
like... Yeah, it's like...
It's bad news.
Yeah, that's exactly how I react every single time I hear him say that.
Do you know
that?
I just go into my cocoon.
That's the easiest.
I love I think somebody made a meme where it was like when you're with your buddies and you're May and you hear McCree's Deadeye go off and it's got like the target on your buddy and you're already cocooned and you just like leave them and you're like right next to each other and you just leave them to
die. All you have to do.
Do you know the rarest trophy in Overwatch?
It's the Smooth as Silk, though, right?
No.
No?
I have Smooth as Silk.
I do too.
Isn't that
hilarious?
Silk?
Smooth as Silk is where you scoped headshot somebody as Widowmaker while you're in the air.
Wow,
and
you guys both got it.
Mine was a complete accident.
Mine was
just
too.
Like,
oh
closed.
Man, no, mine was the biggest nothing of all time. Like I was on like just a bridge, like a railway or whatever, in Volskaya, and I was attempting to snipe and doing horribly the whole game. And then like I heard a Junkrat coming from my left, so I turned, still scoped. He did a grenade at me. It kind of popped me up. Him moving me managed me to get the headshot.
That's exactly how I got mine.
I know, and it was like, mine there we go.
We were playing on King's Row.
That's hilarious. That doesn't count. Take it away. You guys should be stripped away.
Farrah was up high. She shot her concussion blast as I was aiming at her, so it knocked me back right as I fired, and it hit the headshot and gave me the trophy. It clicked and dinged and showed me that I got it, and I was like, wait, was that the one I think it is?
I didn't even, when I got the trophy, I didn't even know what it was. And I was like, hey, what's smooth as silk? And everyone online was like, oh! But the rarest one is actually Zenyatta's Rapid Discord.
Oh my God.
I'm Zenyatta all the time. What is that? Rapid Discord is where you have to Discord and subsequently kill four people. Kill or assist four people in the space of... Zenyatta is the one that does, like, he's the floating guy.
He shoots the orbs. He's the purple one.
Yes. Okay. And if you Discord four people in a row, but the space of time you have...
It's like 6 seconds.
It's ridiculous.
So you Discord, someone dies. Yeah. Discord, someone dies.
And what's funny is... Four in 6 seconds. And a lot of people have, like, videoed it and also timed it. And objectively, they should have gotten it. But because of the way the game happens, they aren't getting it.
Yeah.
So that's a case where I kind of feel like maybe it needs some tweaking.
Well, and
because it seems to not be functioning.
And Zenyatta's been nerfed. So it was way easier to get it.
It's like, no,
at the beginning of the game.
And even then, it was still almost impossible. So it's like they need to do something to kind of balance that trophy back out, because I mean, you know, it's kind of fun that nobody can get it and it's the rarest one, but at the same time, cool. I want it.
I know.
Man, just let me have it.
I only have a few of the ones that you can get regardless of who you are. Like, I'm trying to get the one where you have to destroy three of Symmetra's teleporters in a game.
Oh yeah, I don't have that one.
That one's hard. I can't remember what the other. Oh, get 50 items for a character.
Oh yeah,
you know, I could do that one anytime, but
and that
I could get that one by like spending.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's time, and then also I could spend some money on that too. But I actually went and looked. I only have four characters that I don't have that I still need at least two
really?
That I don't have one for. Zenyatta, Lucio, Torbjörn, and Junkrat.
Oh, Torbjörn.
I still need to get both.
Get some armor.
Which technically. I do have one of Torbjörn. You guys messed me up.
Torbjörn.
I do have one of his trophies, the raid wipe one, where you kill four people with molten core.
Oh, you do?
But what happened is, you and I were actually playing.
Oh, really?
When it happened, we were playing on Numbani, and I set off my ults right as they were making a huge push at the payload. But something like my connection got shoddy, something like that, and the game froze and my system crashed.
I remember that.
And so then I was like, dang, that sucks. I felt like I was doing good that game. I turned it back on and logged back on, and my hero gallery had a new emblem.
Oh.
And I went to it. It was Torbjörn, and it said, and I got his spray that was for completing the raid wipe, but it didn't tick the trophy because
no.
So I don't know if that's going to prevent me from getting a platinum because
you might
like
have
that
to
one
do
trophy.
It again.
Yeah.
I know, and I don't know if
it, even if I do it again,
if it will ping
actually
the trophy.
Work. Yeah, maybe it's like it
that
had it the perfect
sucks.
Moment.
I took screenshots of it, and like when I got the win, and I still don't have the trophy. So if
email
I know
it.
I do
send
it,
send those to Blizzard.
No,
yeah.
I definitely
or
will.
Sony or whatever.
I definitely will be like, hey, I did this, and it didn't give me the trophy.
I want this trophy.
Well, because if I get everything else and I can't get that
one,
that'll
irk you.
Oh, that'll drive me
Bro
crazy.
Bro Mogan has been trolling for the quad kill molten core for what feels like 1,000
it's hard
years.
To get.
And so we're
because they've nerfed him too.
Yeah, so they nerfed him and he keeps going Turbier, and we're like, come on, bro, give up. We want to win this time.
Nope. I have other priorities. Thank you.
I do always feel like such a scumbag when like you're clearly just trophy hunting and you're kind of dragging everybody down very blatantly, and it's like, I'm sorry.
Don't be those people.
It's only in quick play. It's fine.
Yeah, that's how I am too. It's sad.
There's a this is the exact opposite probably of Overwatch, both game and when it came out. But for the Xbox 360, one of the launch games that came with it came on the system. It's called Hexic HD, and it's a puzzle game. And if you can imagine, it basically looks kind of like Tetris. It's like tall with different colored hexagons.
Ooh,
that
okay.
Are sort of scattered throughout, red, green, blue, yellow, and then as you progress, more colors get introduced. All you're trying to do is make little clusters of three or four or five, and when you do that of the same color, and when you do that, they disappear, and you get points, and more colors come
down.
Yeah,
kind of just really like Tetris. Simple. Gotcha.
But the way that the controller works, you have this white outline that's also a hexagon, but it's bigger, and you turn it. So basically, you're turning. It's like a Rubik's Cube. You know what I mean? You're turning these colors to try to match them up with these other ones while trying to avoid these other things, right? There's bombs that come down. Oh. You're trying to avoid the bombs and stuff like that. If you are able, and people that know this game are obviously going to be able to visualize this much better. If you are able to get five or six colors, like six red hexagons, these little hexagons, if you're able to spin everything correctly and make them all surround one other hexagon of a different color, that one in the middle turns into a star. And that's like a pretty good if you can do that, right? You're getting good at hexing. That's the goal. If you can get six stars, so that means you got to build six stars inside this little panel. And if they drop to the bottom, you can't really turn them anymore. So it's tricky stuff. If you get six stars, do the exact same thing, put them around one other hexagon, you get a black pearl. If you can get six black pearls.
This is builds.
It just keeps going. If you can get six black pearls in one space, surround them, surround one hexagon with six black pearls, you get the black pearl poobah, I think is the achievement.
Yeah.
Okay.
The grand black pearl poobah.
I thought you were
like going to
say you get a white pearl, and then if you get six white
and
pearls,
then
you
just
white
goes pearl, on forever. And then, listen, wait.
Then you get a diamond, and then after you do
it.
Diamond.
Grand pearl poobah, that's what it's
grand
called.
Grand pearl poobah. That's hilarious.
So speaking of achievements that Ali never got but always tried to get, that was it. I think the best I could do, you get an achievement if you get three black pearls into a cluster. I think I could do that. But man, I don't know anybody. Me and my buddy always kept trying to get six black pearls around one. I mean, just to get a black pearl was hard enough.
Right.
In the position of six, it was just insane. So I never got that one achievement for Hexic, and I always
remember. Imagine how much benefit your brain got, though, from attempting to do
this.
It's
a great
puzzle
game. I know. We were like, all right, let's think about this. You know,
how can we do it?
If you had kept going down that path, you could be working in like the greatest physics. Oh, you could
be a very different person. Nice to meet you. You know?
Nice to meet you.
Hello. I'd like to be a robot.
You'd have
man.
Like a persistent twitch.
Yeah.
So one of my favorite trophies that I got, I remember it was actually from Far Cry Primal. Now I know Smooth as Silk is, you know, one of the rarest trophies I've probably ever won, but because it did feel like a semi-accident, I'm not as proud of that one.
It's like it doesn't count.
This one I'm super proud of because what it was is you had to get a kill with a bow and arrow from 70 feet away or more.
In what game?
Far Cry Primal.
Oh, that is tough.
So, and this isn't like other Far Cry games where your bow and arrow, you can put like a reticle, like a little, you know, some kind of advanced crosshair with some zoom on it, you know. It's legitimately like you have your bow and it has like two little notches or like a notch, and that's like you like kind of aim it, but you got to like aim it up, you know, and all this other stuff. And so we're sitting, you know, and so it timed out perfectly where this one time I was up on this cliff and I saw some bad guys across this river from me. And the thing is, too, you really have no idea how far that is. It's totally so every time I would come to somebody far away, I'd be like,
right. It's just quick guess. You know?
Quick guess. That looks far enough. And so I
right.
And so this how this was. I saw these people across this river, and I was up on this cliff, cool. And it was really hard. And I saw them, but like they were far enough away. They're like
were they
tiny
moving?
Little specks. Yeah.
Oh,
and
wow.
So well, what happened is I shot this cage that was containing an animal, and so it released this like jaguar or whatever that started killing people on my side of the river. And so this person like from over started running over. That's how I even saw them.
Yeah.
And so they started running across the river and I saw it. And then the jaguar like ran off somewhere else. So the person like turned and ran away. So I started like shooting at him or whatever to scare him. And so he started running back across the river. So same thing. Like I just pulled it.
Oh my God.
Like what I thought was like the correct distance. Like the correct angle and all this stuff, and then just started leading him and let it fly. And like, you know, it's an arrow, so it had travel time. So I let it fly and I'm sitting there
put down your controller.
And then like it's going, and then the experience bonus pops up for killing somebody. And I was like, ha-ha! Yes!
I did it.
And but then I was like, and the trophy?
And I was like, oh, yes! Awesome.
Nice. Bullseye That's is what that one was.
I like that was a wait and hold your breath. Yeah. Kind
so
of
I actually, I mean, it was a very fast second, but it's one of those things like, it's like,
right.
It's like when, like in a movie where the where it cuts back to the crowd watching to the arrow, to the crowd, right, to the right, arrow, right, to the crowd. Right. And it's like, but it's what how it felt in my head, but actually it's probably more like,
Yeah.
So I screen, I saved a clip of it. I'll show you guys.
Oh, it, yeah, cool. I want to see cool. that.
It's hilarious.
Coming soon but to that the Team Chat Facebook.
No, I will. I'll put it up there.
There you go.
But no, that was probably my proudest achievement, like just because of skill. They had another one like you had to kill somebody with a spear who was 50 feet away, and that one took a while too, but it felt way better to do it with a bow and arrow.
That's awesome.
I know my proudest achievement, but do you have a proud achievement?
I would have to think about it. Yeah. I don't really, you know, I'm not achievement oriented.
You're not, you're not really hunting for him.
Not really hunting for him.
mine is Gray Fox.
For what?
From Oblivion.
Oh, yeah?
Yes, and that is completing the entirety of the Thieves Guild, which Ooh. I felt very close to in Oblivion. It was like, again, it was a
perfect... You do love that stealth.
I do, and it was just the perfect time, like when I was playing it, like my age and everything about it just was such an honor to join the guild and do the deeds.
Be honored as one among the ranks.
Yes, and the Gray Fox was a character that led the guild, and just to get into it was a you know, I mean, it's not like crazy hard or anything. But right. if you know, at the time, I was like, okay, I got to beat out these other thieves. Basically, you get lined up, and they're like, which one's the best thief? And you guys need to prove it to us by go stealing this, that, and the other over in the Imperial City. And you have to basically beat them. You have to. There's like a time limit or something.
Oh wow!
Beat them. So they're like, all right, you're in, and you answer to the Gray Fox, and you're like, who's the Gray Fox? And they're like, shut up. No one knows who the Gray Fox is. No one will ever know. And he wears this hooded mask, so you don't even know what he looks like.
Damn.
And you do a bunch of quests. On it goes, and they get increasingly more hard, obviously. And there's a point in the game, and I think I'm getting this right. You meet a queen, and she talks about her late husband who passed away. And she's telling you this story. This might be even like not even associated with the Thieves Guild. It might be with another quest. And she tells you the story, and that's that. You get that information. You go. You continue doing this Thieves Guild, and eventually you get to work with the Gray Fox. And you have to steal an Elder Scroll, which is like this insane like quest.
Hey, that's the name of the game series.
What do you know?
And they're all guarded by either they're blind monks or they're monks with.
Blindfolds?
You know, blindfolds on. I can't remember. And they just listen. So you have to be Ooh. Very... That's how they guard the Elder Scroll. It's very mystical and magical. And I think you work with him at the very end. This is a spoiler, but at the very end, you're in a room with him, and he's like, oh, that was the greatest achievement of my life, or whatever. And he takes off the mask, and you see who he is for the first time, and he gives you the mask, and he says, you are now... the Gray Fox.
Oh, that's awesome.
And you know, I don't remember what I did, but I was like, wow. You know, like what a journey through the Thieves Guild.
That
was
right.
Excellent. And back to the queen. He's like, I want you to come with me. And you go to this castle. I think I'm getting this right. I'm probably butchering it. But I think I remember this. And I went. You go to the queen, and you're just standing. You're the silent protagonist. So you're just kind of standing there. And you're just like looking. And he comes around the corner, and she's like, it's you, my husband. And so he had gone away and got caught up in this thief life.
The thief life.
I don't know what happened exactly, but
he's like, actually this like high up royal dude.
He's
in
a
disguise.
Royal dude, and he's like, "I'm sorry, I've left you for so long." And you're just kind of standing there, like,
what
"Wow,
a
like
what's happening?"
No, I think he had just cause for whatever the fuck happened because he seemed like a good dude. But yes, becoming the Gray Fox.
That's nice. Pretty cool.
Was really fun, and whenever I think of Oblivion, I think about going to the waterfront to meet with the clan.
Oh, man. That's awesome.
Under the lanterns.
Under the lanterns.
Oh, coming back.
You're such a stealth nerd.
I love stealth.
You gotta try Deus Ex then, man.
I know. Deus Ex sounds like right up my alley.
It'd be right up your alley. So I was looking because I am trying to like figure out like I was looking and I actually have several games that I'm just right at the cusp. If I probably put a little bit more time into it, I could platinum up. So I went and like looked on my PlayStation Network of my top 10 like completed games and all that stuff. And obviously Far Cry Primal with 100%. The Order 1886, I'm actually sitting at 80% with. Okay. So I'll probably try to knock that one out. Nice. Then Far Cry 4, I'm at 79. Severed, 72%.
Ooh.
Shadow of Mordor. This one, now this thing counts all DLC. And since I haven't bought the DLC for it, that's what it's counting. Okay. So I'm only 72% on that one. Overwatch, I'm 71%.
Nice.
God of War, the first one, 71%. That one, one of the trophies of that one is you have to beat it in a certain amount. You have to beat the whole game in a certain amount of time for the God of War one. That one would be fun. And then Far Cry 3, 67%. Assassin's Creed Brotherhood, 62.
That's almost an F.
And then Duke Nukem 3D, 61%. Nice. I thought it was interesting that I had all three Far Cry games that I've played are in like the top 10 of completion. Nice. I must really like that game series or something.
I really do wish that The Legend of Zelda had these types of achievements. Yeah,
that'd be awesome. Because
I do everything. Right. I do every stupid thing you can.
Yeah.
There should be an achievement for breaking every single pot you've encountered the entire game.
Yeah, like break 1,000 pots or something like
that. Cut all the grass in Hyrule Field. Yeah. I will, thank you.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Nintendo Switch should have
because they're open world-ish, you know, games, so it's like those are perfect for achievements and stuff like that. Because a lot of those are based on discovery and exploration.
And that's the perfect game for silly trophies. That's such a good game for just the stupidest stuff.
Tell Navi to shut up 10 times.
What's that bird egg thing? It's totally off topic. What's that bird egg shell creature in Twilight Princess?
Bird
Kukuru?
Egg shell.
That can teleport you?
Kookaburra.
Uku.
Uku.
Because it's cuckoo like inverted.
Okay. It's so weird looking.
Oh,
it's like
man.
A humanoid.
Yeah,
like,
it's creepy.
Creepy thing.
Yeah, it's like a really small harpy, but creepier. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah.
I was listening to Zora's theme on repeat recently.
Nice. It's a great good piece of music.
Nice.
Well, I do actually have a moment with Mogan.
Let's do it if
our achievement talk is winding down.
I believe it is. Yes. I think we've covered about all we can cover.
Our accomplishments and failures enough.
I believe so.
All right, so.
Can you go ahead and hit the camera? I know it's not up, but just that way we don't have that long, annoying black pause.
I think that there was actually a lot of news that happened this past week that I kind of missed out on because I've been...
So real quick, this one's going out in 2 weeks. Is any of this going to be like time sensitive where like...
Somewhat.
Okay, that's fine.
But I mean...
It doesn't really matter.
A lot of it's kind of future focused.
No, we're recording this one in advance, so some of this news might be old news, but it's news.
Sorry, news is news. I'm just not going to list any dates. All right, so just a cute, cool little FYI for Nintendo. The pre-orders for Pokemon Sun and Moon have beaten the record for Nintendo.
Really?
Wow. Pokemon Sun and Moon have collectively gotten the most pre-orders in Nintendo history, period.
Wow.
I think that's pretty amazing.
That's pretty good.
Surprising,
and
that
attests to the success of the 3DS.
Yeah.
Because that's a console, hand quotes there, that is so popular, but I feel like no one I know plays, and yet the numbers show it's wildly popular, and Pokemon Sun and Moon
is
clearly got
but now I feel like
to
get a Switch.
But now I might as well just get a Switch.
Yeah, Porqué no los dos.
Huh?
Why not both?
That's true.
I mean, don't you watch taco commercials?
I love that commercial.
That one is good. I do love sending that picture. Just like, why not both?
That's hilarious.
But I do. What was I going to say? Lost my thought. Oh, I bet after the Switch comes out, like because the 3DSs will probably go fairly cheap or be able to find them fairly cheap.
The Switch is a handheld,
and
though,
the
right?
3DS has been going strong for a long time.
It might not.
So it's possible that the Switch could sort of semi-replace it, but considering how much of a powerhouse it has been for Nintendo,
this is true.
I think it would take them a while before they really started phasing it out. I mean, eventually it happens to every console, but I think it is probably still going to be a little while longer. So that's just little Nintendo news. And then for those of us who love RPGs, Square Enix, like JRPGs kind of, Square Enix is making vague hints at a new Final Fantasy game for iOS and Android.
It's going to be a disaster.
Indeed. I don't know how I feel about
that.
Indeed.
Tip of the hat to
good sir. And
with
then
that adieu.
And with that adieu. And then coming soon /out now/out in the past. Not sure where we're at in the timeline, of course. So these are kind of backwards. Dishonored 2 is coming out or came out, etc.
Well, let's just say today is October 28.
We've dated ourselves. Uh-oh. Oh, no.
Yeah, we've dated ourselves.
When we're recording this episode. So take that,
prophets.
Take that as you will as to what time
so the
all
point
this stuff
is,
comes out.
On November 11th, Dishonored 2 officially hit Xbox, PS4, and PC. So Xbox One, PS4, and PC now have or will have Dishonored 2, which I'm super looking forward to.
Are you getting it?
Yes. Oh, okay. I'm going to get it. Absolutely. And then we have game I have not heard a single thing about, which is a little strange. Mario Party Star Rush is coming to the 3DS November 4th. So this one is definitely going to be a past game. So Mario Party Star Rush came out November 4th for the 3DS. So you can get it now. Okay. Call of Duty Infinite Warfare, same thing, November 4th. Did you cancel your pre-order?
So let me say this. I'm going on with this. After much deliberation, and I played the beta of Infinite Warfare, had fun with it. It was fun. It was some great fast-paced action. The weapons handled nicely. I liked that some additions that it had to the gameplay, like you actually had your at health bars and stuff like that, that you could see above your enemies' heads and things like that, which kind of gave it a cool, and some other things that gave it a cool futuristic feel. Obviously, you're in space for some of the missions and things like that. But ultimately, I was not blown away.
And a pre-order requires being blown away.
And to an extent, yes. And again, like I've said, I was in it for mostly Modern Warfare Remastered. But as I was playing the beta, which again, like I said, I liked it. Well, I was still not like, you know what? I don't feel like paying $80 for a remastered game because that's what I'm going to probably wind up playing more than this.
Yeah, that's a good point.
And so, you know, hopefully they'll wind up releasing remastered as a standalone.
I feel like
the actual sales numbers of Infinite Warfare are like, or they hear a lot of feedback of, nah, I'm not buying this. I've seen it everywhere. People be like, I'm not buying this. Just I'm going to wait for a standalone remaster. Yeah. So ultimately at the end of the day, I was like, and also I'm coming off fresh of Black Ops 3 just not being what I wanted it to be.
Yeah.
And so all those factors combined, I was like, you know what? I don't want to pay this much money to be moderately excited about one game and then really like a game that came out several years ago that's, you know, now remastered when I'd rather spend that money on something that,
that's what I'm saying,
on a new experience. And then also true, yes, it's
exactly
a terrible consumer model.
Let 'em know.
Of packaging. You have to buy this game to get this game,
right,
you know, because they know that this game is the game that people are more excited about.
Mm-mm, don't give them your money, Jarrett.
Man, yeah.
With that,
join
with all
the
those,
light side.
All those factors,
the dark side.
All those factors combined and wanting a new experience and wanting to try something new. Yeah, I canceled my pre-order for Call of Duty and bought Battlefield 1 instead. And am having the time of my fucking life in it.
Mother
it's
nice.
Awesome.
Nice. And then I know these
hear
are definitely going to be in the future, of
yes
course. Watch Dogs 2.
Oh,
yeah,
yes.
I forgot about that one. Watch Dogs 2
end
hits November 15th.
Nice.
Yeah, so actually right in the middle of November, PS4, Xbox, and PC. And then, of course, Pokemon Sun and Moon, November 18th. It's
so
close.
Soon. It is
it's
so
that
soon.
Soon. November 18th. I'm so excited.
Nice.
And I'm still not decided if I'm going to get Sun or Moon.
What do you do?
Poor Kano Los Dos.
What is the difference? Just different starters?
Really, the difference, it's not the starters. It's just like exclusives.
Okay.
Like certain ones will have like specialized Pokemon for that game. And it's like, which ones do I want?
Yes, yes.
And then we also have, of course, Final Fantasy 15 still on deck for November 29th for PS4 and Xbox One.
Oh,
Zach,
you
can,
yeah,
finally,
I can finally
join
play
in.
Final Fantasy. Oh, I've played Final Fantasy. I love that series.
Yeah,
it's great.
Whatever.
I can be a fraud.
a stable in
very
anyone's
good at that
game library.
And yeah, that's what's coming out for the next foreseeable future.
Nice.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I'm really excited about Watch Dogs 2. I'll pick it up. I probably won't be able to snatch it on release. Because I'll be leaving for Europe like very soon after it comes out, so why get it on
take your PlayStation
day
with you?
I'm not doing that.
Funny.
That's an expensive. That's a gamble.
That's a gamble.
but no, I do want to get that game because even though the first Watch Dogs had issues, and you know, with story and mechanics and some gameplay stuff like that, I still really enjoyed it and thought it had a lot of potential. From what I'm hearing about Watch Dogs 2, it lives up to what the original Watch Dogs should
have been. Remember the hype episode. Easy.
That's why it's not pre-ordered.
That train just
don't emotionally
by
commit to anything.
That's why it's not pre-ordered.
Okay.
You know, I'll wait and see how that one goes with
nice
reviews and stuff
nice
too, but I am very excited about that game.
All right, cool.
Well, with that, So yeah, we've talked about some achievements, some of our favorites, and what we feel they bring to the game. So please let us know what some of your favorite achievements that you've or trophies that you've collected throughout your gaming exploits have been. Let us know by sending us an email at teamchatpodcast@gmail.com, or preferably posting it on our Facebook wall at teamchatfacebook.com/teamchatpodcast. Like us or follow us on Twitter at teamchatpodcast. And then you can also, you know, the other way of getting a hold of us on YouTube also, reply in the comments to this video.
First,
yeah. You could be first on all of them.
You could be first on all.
That's an achievement for the Team Chat podcast.
Team Chat achievements.
We should start doing achievements, like win 5 song contests. That's an achievement. Ooh.
Bro Mogan's creeping up.
Oh, 10. 10 song contests.
we can put an achievement on the video right here.
Yeah.
You can make that.
Yeah, right? I can make that. Achievement. I can do that. We'll do that. We'll look into
says
that.
Like a word.
Make some achievements.
Or
yeah.
100 bingo. Insults emailed to right. Team Chat.
Team Chat bingo.
Well done. Good job, sir.
But 50 tip of the hats.
Yes. Tip of the hats. That's our screen.
Tip of the hats, sir.
Tip of the hats for you.
8 tip of the hats for you, sir.
Very good.
But yeah, so let us know, because we always like to hear from our listeners. But with that, ladies and gentlemen, this brings another episode of Team Chat Podcast to a close. Podcast.
Podcastic.
It's a podcastic podcast.
That's going to be on iTunes next week.
Future President Jerrett will be giving you the song hint for this upcoming, for the song contest for this episode, as well as with the segment of that song. But until next time, I'm one of your hosts, Jerrett Wilson, joined to my right by Rachel Mogan.
Adios.
And to my left, Zachary Parks.
Peace out.
We'll see you all next time. Stick around for the song. All right, everybody, here is the song hint for this episode, provided again by Andrew Mogan. It is, making it to the end will suffice, but you'll get a secret ending if you collect all the gems. One more time. Making it to the end will suffice, but you'll get a secret ending if you collect all the gems. And now, here's the song.